Hello everyone, how are you? My name is Prakhar Srivastav and I welcome you to this lecture on Unacademy, your own very own channel, that is Unacademy Gate MEPIXE. And today we are going to discuss about the next step of welding processes. So whatever we have discussed till now was one by one we have seen each and every process. And let me open the slides for you. Yes. So these are the slides. So the discussion we were carrying in the last lecture was on Mission Gate 2021 and 2022. And my name is Prakhar Srivastav. I, along with 10 other people, presenting you this particular course on Unacademy. Most of us are from top-notch institutes like IITs, NITs, IISCs. And we are ourselves topper of Gate. I secured All India 3rd rank in Gate 2016. Then I took admission into IIT Bombay and finally I completed my master's from NITI Mumbai. Okay? So in industrial engineering. So today my throat is not that good, but to continue with your preparation, I don't want any lag. So that is why I'll be making a video today. And one very important thing is that I'll not be shouting today. I'll not be screaming today because I don't think that I'm in a state of doing so. So don't let me scream. I want, if you are able to understand, please do reply, and my team is there to help you out. If you are commenting anything, they will be replying. I will not be replying. Take care, in the video lecture, they will be replying right now. And apart from that, you can, dekho, koi bhi dikkat ho, please reach out to me on Facebook. If you have any issue, please reach out to me on Facebook. Second, if you want to buy anything on Unacademy, you can use my referral code Prakhar21 to get flat 10% off. Prakhar21 to get flat 10% off. And if you are facing any issue in industrial engineering, manufacturing or mathematics, you can directly reach out to me. Theek hai? Chalo. So all these things were discussed, and I'll start from the point where we left in the last lecture. That is, we have discussed about gas welding. Ye sari cheeze humne discuss kari thi. I hope you remember this thing. Last lecture mein shayad clarity mein koi dikkat thi, to main fir se pura dikha deta hun. Then we have started with gas welding, that there are two cylinders, one of oxygen, other one of acetylene. In required proportion, we make oxygen and acetylene and we get the flame. Depending upon the quantity of oxygen with respect to acetylene, we get either oxidizing flame, neutral flame or reducing flame. So then we have discussed about neutral flame first. Okay? Then there are two types of cones that are formed in neutral flame. The inner white cone and the outer blue flame. Now, if you increase the quantity of acetylene, you get a carburizing flame, because there will be some amount of carbon that will not be burnt. And this you can say high temperature carbon, which is not burnt, it enters into the weld pool and weld pool starts boiling. So that is a representation of a carburizing flame. That is a sign of a carburizing flame. That is boiling weld pool. Okay? Then we have covered the different parts, that why, when carburizing flame is used, when oxidizing flame is used, what do you mean by oxidizing flame? See, there are three cones in carburizing flame. Whereas when it comes to oxidizing flame, it is almost similar to the neutral flame, but just that the inner white cone becomes more smaller. Okay? So now there are sounds, hissing sound, sparking sound, okay, normal sound. So you can identify a flame with the help of sound, with the help of, by seeing the weld pool. If the weld pool is having sparks, it means that it is an oxidizing flame. If it is having a boiling, the weld pool is boiling, it means that it is a carburizing flame. And if nothing is there, it means that it is a neutral flame. ठीक है, चलो, all these things we have covered. ठीक है, तो gas welding पूरा हो गया था, and from today we'll start with thermite welding. So I am using yellow color, but I don't think that yellow color will be visible to you because this software is not accepting yellow color, you can say. चलो, give the heading thermite welding. Thermite welding. THERMITE, thermite welding. Sir, what do you mean by thermite welding? ठीक है, आप स्टार्ट करने जा रहे हैं, प्लीज बी अटेंटिव गाइस. आई डोंट वांट एनी न्यूसेंस. यू कैन ऑल दीज ऑल दोज हु आर सीइंग दिस इन द प्रीमेड फॉर्मेट लाइव और यू कैन से इन द रिकॉर्डेड फॉर्मेट, यू डोंट हैव टू वरी अबाउट एनीथिंग. यू कैन रीच आउट टू मी एट एनी पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम. तो लिखो, पहली बात तो काय के लिए यूज होती है ये. सो इट इज यूज्ड और यूटिलाइज्ड फॉर वेल्डिंग थिक प्लेट्स, THICK प्लेट्स, थिक प्लेट्स. इज इट क्लियर? सो इट इज यूज्ड फॉर थिक प्लेट्स, लार्ज क्रॉस सेक्शंस. Then you can say such as locomotive rails. Please remember, जो आपका रेल ट्रैक्स होते हैं ना, रेल ट्रैक्स, वो भी इसी से ज्वाइन होते हैं. ठीक है, ship, ship, it is having in use in ship industry. ठीक है, नाउ प्रोसेस क्या होता है सर? ये सब तो ठीक है, बट व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय प्रोसेस? सो देखो, देयर इज अ केमिकल रिएक्शन. दिस केमिकल रिएक्शन इज एक्सोथर्मिक इन नेचर. इफ इट इज एक्सोथर्मिक इन नेचर, इट गिव्स हाई अमाउंट ऑफ हीट. It releases high amount of heat, due to which melting takes place. And if melting is taking place, all of you know which type of welding process is this. If melting is taking place, which type of welding process is this? Jaldi batao. What do you think? Yes. Most of you are right. Yes. This is fusion welding. Very good. So this is the whole scenario of thermite welding. That's it. इसके अलावा कुछ भी नहीं है. देखो, in welding you have only two things, either heat or pressure. You just have to find out what is the way in which welding is taking place. If melting is done, then fusion is there. If melting is done, fusion is there. Suppose I am applying pressure, then molecular diffusion is the reason of welding. Yes or no? So welding, agar aapko join karna hai, either you melt, allow it to solidify so that they join, or you apply pressure so that particle from one part enters into another. Yahi hota hai, weld karna matlab join karna. Join do hi tarike se hota hai. There are only two ways in which you can join, heat and pressure. That's it. If only heat is used, fusion welding process. If only pressure is used, solid state welding process. When both heat and pressure is used, resistance welding. Yes or no? All the type of these welding processes we have already seen. Yes or no? Now, sir, ye theek hai. Heat tak to theek hai. Heat, melting is fine. Exothermic reaction is there. That is also fine. But, what about this chemical reaction? How this chemical reaction is taking place? What is the component such that such a high amount of heat is generated through this exothermic reaction? Yes or no? So let us dig deep into that part. Theek hai, chalo. I'll just check that everything is going fine or not. Yes, is it fine? Yes, I think that it is fine. Theek hai, chalo. Chalo. So, please pay attention. Now you have to write down the equation. So equation क्या होती है? Please देखिए. देखो, process क्या होती है? एक हमारा oxide होगा, metal oxide plus another metal, other metal. Now what happens, please pay attention. Now this other metal is selected such that its affinity towards oxygen is high as compared to this metal number 1. This metal number 2 ke paas zyada power hoti hai oxygen ke sath rehne ki. So what happened? M2O, that is second metal, that is the other metal, it takes this oxide, plus metal 1 remains alone. And when the bond between M1O is there na, M1O plus M2, so when this bond is broken, when this bond of M1O is broken, energy is released. So that is why it is accompanied by high energy. High energy. Is it clear to all of you? Is this thing clear to all of you? I don't think you would be having any doubt. Now, this high energy is utilized in welding. This high energy is utilized in welding. Sir, ye sab to theek tha. But I am only concerned with high energy. So you tell us the mixture that we need to take here. That's it. We want very high energy. So you just tell us, you just please tell us that what is the mixture that we have to take here. So dekho. Most commonly used mixture is Fe3O4 plus aluminium. Now, aluminium is having higher affinity towards oxygen. So it forms Al2O3 plus metal 1 will remain alone plus 3 megajoule of energy per mole is released. So can you see what is the high amount of energy that is released? This is one of the most common mixtures. Okay, this is known as most common thermite mixture. Now, let us balance this equation. So if you try to go out to balance this equation, how it will look? 3 Fe4, okay, plus 3 Fe4, so 9 Fe aa gaya yahan pe. If 9 Fe is there, aluminium is 2 2 into 4 is 8, okay, so 4, so yahan aa gaya 8 aluminium. This is the balanced equation. This is the balanced thermite equation. That is, you take Fe3O4, aluminium, you mix them up. When you mix, your heat is released. Now I am concerned with this heat because it is utilized in welding. This heat is utilized in welding. If any one of you is having any doubt, please let me know. Theek hai? Theek hai, chalo. Ab dekho, ye sab to ho gaya. So about ये temperature कितना generate होता है, तो when you get this, the temperature generated is about 2500 degree Celsius. 2500 degree Celsius, that is very very important to you, that is very very important for you. Is it clear to all of you? Is this thing clear to all of you? ठीक है, ये पहली बात थी. चलो, now is there only one thermite mixture? Is there only one thermite mixture? No. Just a second. There is some issue, I think. Hello, hello, hello. Am I audible and visible? Yes. Am I audible? Yes. There might be some signal interaction. ठीक है, चलो. So, is there only one thing that we used instead of Fe3O4? You can use CuO also, copper oxide can also be used इज इट क्लियर? बिकॉज कॉपर के साथ भी यही होगा, बट द हीट रिलीज इन दिस केस, इन केस ऑफ कॉपर ऑक्साइड वुड बी 1.152 मेगा जूल पर मोल. सो दैट इज वाई वी रिक्वायर लेस हीट. Why we require less heat? So why we have to use a process which is giving us less heat? So that is why the highest amount of heat or energy is released in this only. ठीक है, the most feasible thermite mixture is this. The most feasible thermite mixture is this. Is it clear to all of you? Is it clear? So this is what your thermite mixture is. I don't think that thermite mixture, thermite welding के बारे में आपको और कुछ भी चाहिए. Everything is given. Exothermic reaction is the reason. Fusion welding process reaction आपको पता चल गया, ठीक है. तो let us move to electron beam welding. Let us move to electron beam welding. इलेक्ट्रॉन बीम वेल्डिंग. सर ये इलेक्ट्रॉन बीम वेल्डिंग होता क्या है? नाम तो बहुत अच्छा है, काफी नाम इज वेरी गुड, बट वॉट हैपन्स इन इलेक्ट्रॉन बीम वेल्डिंग? वाई डू यू थिंक दैट वी कैन परफॉर्म इलेक्ट्रॉन बीम वेल्डिंग? वाई डू यू थिंक सो? तो देखो, अच्छा एक चीज बता दो, अपार्ट फ्रॉम वेल्डिंग हाउ मेनी ऑफ यू नो अबाउट टेड? हाउ मेनी ऑफ यू नो अबाउट टेड? सो टेड टॉक्स आर वन ऑफ द मोस्ट कॉमन थिंग्स आउट देयर, बिकॉज टेड टॉक इज अ प्लेटफॉर्म वेयर द पीपल हु हैव गेन्ड सक्सेस, they come and they throw some light on their strategies, on their lifestyle, how the life transformed from the like before getting successful and after getting successful. ठीक है, so this is an amazing thing. So I was telling you there are some videos that you need to see. First video I have already told you, I think, by Amy Cuddy. She was the speaker. Fake it till you make it. ठीक है, सेकेंड आई डोंट नो द नेम, यू कैन गो फॉर दिस वीडियो, फिबोनाची नंबर्स. ठीक है, फिबोनाची नंबर्स, ट्राई टू सी, जस्ट टाइप टेड टॉक्स ऑन फिबोनाची नंबर्स, फिबोनाची नंबर्स. ठीक है, इट इज एन अमेजिंग थिंग. आई होप यू रिमेंबर फिबोनाची नंबर्स. दिस सपोज द सीरीज, फिबोनाची नंबर की सीरीज किसको पता है? मोस्टली देखो क्या होता है, 0 1, 0+1 इज 1, 1+1 इज 2, 1+2 इज 3, 2+3 is 5, 3+5 is 8, 5+8 is 13. So this is Fibonacci series, and you won't believe that this is it. This is like looking very simple to you, but you can say that 90% prediction of share market happens with the help of Fibonacci numbers. ठीक है, the things that are there in Fibonacci series. ठीक है, वो चीजें आपको बहुत ज्यादा ब्यूटीफुल लगती है. फॉर एग्जाम्पल सनफ्लावर, सो द नंबर ऑफ पेटल्स इन सम सनफ्लावर, इट फॉलोज अ पर्टिकुलर पैटर्न. ठीक है, व्हाई सनफ्लावर लुक्स ब्यूटीफुल टू यू? बिकॉज ऑफ द रीजन दैट इट इज हैविंग द नंबर इन फिबोनाची सीरीज. आई डोंट नो व्हाट इज हैपनिंग, बट आई होप दैट आई एम ऑडिबल. एंड ठीक है, चलो, सो दैट इज वाई. देखो, वेन द रूम्स आर डिजाइंड, वी ट्राई टू कीप द लेंथ, विड्थ एंड हाइट इन अ प्रॉपर रेशियो सच दैट इट फॉर्म्स फिबोनाची सीरीज. फॉर एग्जाम्पल 3:2:1, दिस पार्ट विल लुक वेरी क्लियर एंड वेरी ब्यूटिफुल टू यू. इफ अ रूम इज यू कैन से इज कंस्ट्रक्टेड इन सच अ वे that one coordinate is 3, other is 2 and 1 is 1, third one is 1, or rather you can say 8, 5, 3 also. For example, here 3, 5 and this is 8. So, ये चीजें बहुत ज्यादा important होती हैं and this is an absolutely amazing thing. ठीक है, just try to go back and understand what Fibonacci numbers are and believe me, Fibonacci numbers is one of the number series that is going to create revolution in coming future. ठीक है, बहुत सारी चीजें predict हो जाती हैं, बहुत सारी चीजें. Is it clear? चलो, let us come back to our lecture on electron beam welding. And there is a very good song also of TED song. ठीक है, TED Talks में actually there is no song, but someone has taken the different you can say saying from different TED Talks, saying from different TED Talks and like incorporated some music in it and a song is made, TED Talk. ठीक है, TED Talks of you can say the great creativity is more magical and now you need that magic, the miracles of your mind. So you can see the world as it, isn't it? You can imagine the future. You can remember the past. बहुत सही गाना है. That is an absolutely amazing song. The great creativity is more magical. And now you need that magic. It's an amazing song. So कोई गाना नहीं है वो. It is actually taken. See, there are various TED Talks. So in TED Talks में से parts उठाए गए हैं. And those parts are like with along these parts are played along with music, so it appears to be like a song, but it is a very good song. ठीक है, चलो, you just go back and see. Now, sir, what do you mean by electron beam welding? तो देखो, please draw the setup along with me. Here is your cathode gun. Now, your cathode gun may be tungsten, maybe made up of tungsten. ठीक है, कुछ भी हो सकती है. दिस इज योर कैथोड गन. प्लीज पे अटेंशन. हियर यू आर हैविंग, एनोड. कैथोड गन मींस इट इज नेगेटिवली चार्ज्ड. ठीक है, एंड व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय कैथोड गन? दैट इट शूट्स अप द इलेक्ट्रॉन. So electron comes out from here. Since it is cathode, so electron is coming out from here. This is positively charged because it is anode. So don't you think these electrons, they will be accelerated, and now you are having accelerated electrons. ठीक है, accelerated electrons. Now what happens that we try to focus, we place an electromagnetic lens here. Please remember the term electromagnetic lens. So ये जो rays आ रही है ना, they fall on it. Electron comes and falls on it. And you all know what does this lens do? It converges everything to a single point. And surprisingly, your workpiece is kept here. Your two workpieces that needs to be joined, it is kept here. ठीक है, what is this? This is electromagnetic lens. Electromagnetic lens. Now what will happen? See, due to the kinetic energy of electron, when they bombard with the workpiece, the kinetic energy of electron is converted into heat energy. And this heat is utilized for welding. and this heat is utilized for welding. Is it clear to all of you? Is it clear to all of you? तो ये basics होते हैं, ठीक है? Basics यही है. Electron is there, we accelerate it, we using electromagnetic lens, we give it a direction, and when all the electron falls on a workpiece, they collide with the workpiece and all the kinetic energy is converted into heat energy after losses, and this heat is utilized for welding. That's it. This is the principle of electron beam welding. ठीक है, तो लिख लीजिए. Now, the electron here travels with the speed of approximately 50,000 kilometer per second. Approximately 50,000 kilometer per second. Now, यहां पे आप देखेंगे, so this green part, यहां पे एक hole बन जाएगा. This hole is known as keyhole. Because जब drop होगा electron, don't you think it will create a hole? So this is keyhole, and that is why sometimes this process is also known to happen with the help of keyhole phenomena. Keyhole phenomena. Is it clear? Now, is there any external source of heat? No. So that is why this is having EBM, EBW. Electron beam welding has lowest heat affected zone. Lowest heat affected zone, and the penetration is very high. Penetration kya hota hai? Suppose this is a workpiece. I hope you remember the first lecture of welding. Now, this is known to be low penetration. This is more penetration. This depth up to which you are having the welded joint, that is penetration. So that is why it is having very high penetration. That is why this part is having very high penetration. EBW. अच्छा सॉरी, आपको दिख नहीं रहा होगा ना. सॉरी, आई विल ड्रॉ इट हियर. दिस इज नोन एज पार्ट वन एंड पार्ट टू. सो द डेप्थ अप टू विच यू आर हैविंग योर वेल्डेड जॉइंट, दैट इज नोन एज योर, सपोज दिस depth is penetration. I hope you remember this term, that this depth is penetration. So that is why we say that EBM is having very high penetration, or EBW, sorry, electron beam welding is having high penetration. High penetration. Is it clear to all of you? Is it clear to all of you? One important part that I have left here is this. Stylus. The whole procedure is taking place in a closed environment. That is, it is taking place in vacuum environment. Is it clear? It is taking place in vacuum environment. Because if air is there, the air may collide with the electron particles and may deviate it. That is why it is taking place inside a vacuum chamber. Is it clear to all of you? So, vacuum to theek hai. This is clear to all of you. I don't think you would be having any doubt in this. So, electron beam welding is clear to all of you. Theek hai? And I am not making you write whatever I have told you. I have explained you. You can write it in your own words. Or otherwise, join my Telegram channel. I'll share the notes over there. Theek hai? Chalo. Let us move to the next welding process. Laser beam welding. You have to understand the principle from where the heat is coming. That's it. You have to understand the principle from where the heat is coming to weld. That's it. Is it clear to all of you? So, ab kya hota hai? Dekho. I'll again draw the diagram. Now, please pay attention. देखो, ठीक है? यहाँ पे मेरा एक product है. Now what happens that with the help of laser नहीं होती actually, ये मैं बता रहा हूँ आपको concept समझ लो, बाद में laser समझते रहना. उसका नाम, the name of that product is laser, but first understand the concept behind it. Suppose there is a flash lamp. So flash lamp is, it suddenly gives a flash like camera. Yes or no? So the energy is released at once. That energy is taken up and it goes to the upper level. The particle goes to the excited state. ठीक है? This is lower energy level. This is upper energy level. ठीक है? Now what happens? Please pay attention. Here comes the important part. Now what happens? Now after some time, it will release some amount of energy. देखो, your capacity is there. Like for example, you can say there are certain states. That suppose I say that this utensil is there. Now this utensil will be having a capacity. If I fill it up to top, yahan tak if I fill it up the rice, it will have the rice, no problem. But after some time, after the process, the extra rice goes off, falls off, and it comes to a stable state when it is having completely filled rice. That extra rice is gone. So similarly, the extra energy which is not acceptable to atom, that is released and it comes to a state. This state is known as metastable state. Now what happens that your lot of particle comes to this metastable state, and after some time they all release the energy at once and comes down to the ground energy level. When they all come out to energy level, they release photon, and now this photon is accelerated one. ठीक है? So now, in like in electron beam welding, we have used electron. Here we are using this photon to do the welding. Here we are using this photon to do the welding. Is it clear? So now accelerated photon is used instead of electron. Electron beam welding, laser beam welding is same. But in electron beam welding, we are using electron. Whereas in this case, we are using photon. Is it clear? Now, please write down. Atoms are pumped to higher energy level using flash lamp. After some time, these atoms automatically comes to metastable state. Metastable state. When there is sufficient, देखो अब ये photons को release करने के लिए भी you require some energy. So एक atom का काम नहीं होता. When there is sufficient population, then only this photon can be released and atom can come back to the original state. So लिखो, when sufficient population inversion is achieved, when sufficient population inversion is achieved, photon is released and atom comes back to lower energy level. Original state. Is it clear to all of you? Is this thing clear to all of you? यहाँ तक समझ में आया आपको? ठीक है? ये चीज़ जो आपको ऊपर दिख रही है ना, sorry इस साइड दिख रही होगी. ये चीज़ जो आपको ऊपर दिख रही है, that is the only phenomena which is utilized. ठीक है? लिख लीजिए. It is used for welding copper and aluminium alloys. Copper and aluminium alloys and have second least heat affected zone. Least is for electron beam machining, second least is for laser beam machining. Heat affected zone. ठीक है, ठीक है. और ये जो फोटोन होगा ना, ये फोटोन जो रिलीज हुआ है, दैट फोटोन मूव्स इन दिस ट्यूब लाइक दिस. and this is known as laser. This is known as laser. ठीक है, ये सब तो ठीक है. एल्यूमिनियम, टाइटेनियम, फेरस मटेरियल्स, ठीक है, एवरीथिंग इज फाइन. तो क्लियर, दिस इज क्लियर टू ऑल ऑफ यू. ठीक है, एनीथिंग एल्स? सो लेट अस स्टार्ट विथ, सो थ्री मशीनिंग प्रोसेस इज क्लियर टू ऑल ऑफ यू. नाउ द ओनली डिफरेंस, नाउ ऑलमोस्ट लेजर बीम मशीनिंग एंड इलेक्ट्रॉन बीम मशीनिंग इज सेम, बट नो यूज ऑफ वैक्यूम इज देयर. वैक्यूम इज यूज्ड इन इलेक्ट्रॉन बीम मशीनिंग ओनली. ठीक है, चलो एक छोटी सी चीज और लिख लो. ईबीएम प्रोड्यूसेस, इलेक्ट्रॉन बीम वेल्डिंग प्रोड्यूसेस हार्मफुल एक्सरे विच इज अवॉइडेड इन लेजर बीम मशीनिंग. ठीक है, चलो ये हो गया. सो हियर वी कंप्लीट द वेल्डिंग प्रोसेसेस. मोस्टली वी हैव कवर्ड ऑलमोस्ट ऑल द डिफरेंट काइंड्स ऑफ वेल्डिंग प्रोसेसेस. आई होप दैट यू हैव एंजॉयड दिस पार्ट. लेट अस स्टार्ट विद द अलाइड प्रोसेसेस नेक्स्ट. सर, व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय अलाइड प्रोसेसेस? तो देखो, प्लीज पे अटेंशन. टिल नाउ वी वर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द कंपोनेंट्स. आई एम रियली सॉरी कि मैं आपको शाउट आउट नहीं कर पा रहा हूं. एक चीज याद रखिएगा, आप सबको ये कोड याद होना चाहिए, प्रखर 21, PRAKHAR 21. ऑल ऑफ यू रिमेंबर द नेम प्रखर 21. प्रखर 21 आपको पता ही होना चाहिए. ठीक है, मैं बार बार इस चीज का नाम लूंगा बिकॉज That is my identity, and I want all of you to know the identity. That is my identity is Prakhar 21. ठीक है, चलो चलो. So allied processes, देखो, till now we were using either heat or pressure. Suppose your laptop is there. In your laptop, your wire is there. ठीक है, and now this wire is broken. Now this wire is broken. Can you apply heat to it? No, you cannot apply heat to it. Otherwise, it will melt. It will completely melt. It is such a delicate product. Can you apply pressure? No, sir. Pressure से कैसे हो सकता है? This is a very thin wire. ठीक है, then. So is there any third thing that you can apply? No. The welding takes place with the help of only two things. So what we can do? There was a suggestion. Why not to take another product, the third item, keep it in the molten state and apply it over this joint like this. So now don't you think that both the wires are connected and we don't have to melt them also? We have melted the third product. Suppose this is known as solder. So we have melted the third component. We have applied that third component on the joint. We pour it and we keep it in that position. It gets solidified. So the joint is formed and it should be electrically conductive. That's it. Agar ye conducting hai, so the signal from this part will travel to this part without any issue. So only thing you have to keep in mind that it should be electrically conductive. Yes or no? So that is what is known as allied processes. We cannot take place, we cannot perform this at an elevated temperature. ठीक है, we cannot perform it at an elevated temperature. Why? ठीक है, because heat and pressure might hamper the product. It might hamper the product. तो चलो देखते हैं. So, concept समझ में आ गया. So, please note down. So, in allied processes, what we need to study? The first part we will be studying is soldering. And the second part that we will study is brazing. Third part is also there, that is very common in all of our homes, that is adhesives. Adhesive is nothing but glue. जो आपकी glue होती है ना, ठीक है, that is you क्या you what you actually do. Suppose you break your pen from here, what you will do, you put a glue, you fix it up and place it. That's it. So have you think that joining is taking place? Yes or no? Joining is taking place. But is for joining, am I using any heat or pressure? Heat or pressure? No. But the component that I am using in between, jo glue hai, I am using the properties of the glue to join two parts. ठीक है? So that is why this is not a very important topic. That is a very common thing. But you have to know about soldering and brazing in a much better way. So let us start with soldering then. I'll draw the line. ठीक है, चलो. So give the heading soldering. What do you mean by soldering? तो देखो क्या होता है. देखो अब यहां पर आपको एक चीज पता है, यहां पे थ्योरी लिख रहा हूं मैं, दैट वी यूज अ थर्ड फिलर मटेरियल टू जॉइन टू पार्ट्स. To join two parts, yes or no? So when the melting point when the melting point of filler material is above. Now there is a value, please remember this value, is below. -430°C. We call it to have a solder. ठीक है? And obviously it should also have the and also lesser than melting point of the base material. Is it clear to all of you? यहां तक आपको सब समझ में आ गया? ठीक है, that is the melting point of your base material. ठीक है, यहां तक समझने के बाद अब आपको ये चीज पता है कि देखो actually I don't know but I am getting some electric current in the headphones. चलो देखते हैं. But you have to understand, I am not melting the workpiece. I am not melting the base material. ठीक है, that is why your solder melting point should be less than your base metal melting point. Is it clear? Otherwise, if you heat the filler material up to that temperature and you pour it on your joint, don't you think that your base metal will also melt? Yes or no? So that is why your melting point of the filler material is less than the melting point of base metal. That is common in both soldering and brazing, but it is less than 430 also. ठीक है? Now ये filler material होता क्या है? What is this filler material? So please note down. Mostly it is a mixture of lead and 10. Lead and tin is known as solder, and this is only the filler material. This is only the filler material. Is it clear to all of you? Chalo. Application. Mostly, it is used in electronic industry. Mostly it is used in electronic industry. ठीक है? चलो ये हो गया. Now, second give the heading brazing. What is the difference between soldering and brazing? You will come to know now. ठीक है, बहुत सारे लोगों को doubt है that what is the difference between soldering and brazing. ठीक है, तो please pay attention. Similarly, melting point of filler material is more than 430 degrees Celsius but less than 的melting point of the base metal. Is it clear? Second. Now, यहां पर तो the solder is mixture of lead and tin. यहां पे क्या use करते हैं? तो देखो, here we use alloy of copper, zinc. ठीक है, कॉपर, जिंक, कॉपर एंड सिल्वर, कॉपर, जिंक, कॉपर एंड सिल्वर, एंड लाइक दैट इज नोन एज सोल्डर, दिस इज नोन एज स्पेल्टर. इट इज नोन एज स्पेल्टर. ठीक है, थर्ड, स्ट्रेंथ इज मोर as compared to soldered joint. Application. Leak proof joint. Leak proof joint. ठीक है, leak proof joint. ठीक है। अब फॉर बोथ ऑफ द मटेरियल्स, यहां पे लिखना फॉर बोथ ऑफ द मटेरियल्स द टेक्निक क्या होती है, तो जो भी पार्ट्स को ज्वाइन करना होता है ना, वी सिंपली कीप इट लाइक दिस एंड अप्लाई अ ड्रॉप हियर, सो इट गोज इनटू द बोथ द मेटल, इट गोज इन बिटवीन बोथ द मेटल्स थ्रू कैपिलरी एक्शन। In both soldering and brazing, same thing happens, just the material, filler material is different. That's it. Is used. Capillary action is used. ठीक है? चलो, let me check that everything is going fine or not. Everything is going fine. Capillary action is used. ठीक है? चलो, ये हो गया एक part. तो आई डोंट थिंक कि इसके अलावा आपको कुछ पार्ट करने की जरूरत है, ऑलमोस्ट एवरीथिंग इज कंप्लीट। ठीक है, नाउ इन द नेक्स्ट लेक्चर वी विल बी कवरिंग अबाउट द वेल्डिंग डिफेक्ट्स, इन द नेक्स्ट लेक्चर वी विल बी टेकिंग अप द वेल्डिंग डिफेक्ट्स। इसके अलावा एक छोटी सी चीज है जो मिस करी है हमने, वो मैं लेट मी चेक कि कुछ मिस तो नहीं हुआ है, बिकॉज आई थिंक सफिशियंटली वी हैव कवर्ड द एंटायर सिलेबस, सफिशियंटली वी हैव कवर्ड द एंटायर सिलेबस of welding, only welding defect is left. Let me check, if you guys are having any other doubt, you can throw your doubts right now. आप अपने doubts पूछ सकते हैं, ठीक है। Laser beam welding is done, soldering brazing is done, electron beam welding is done, ठीक है। Explosive welding वाला part cover up हो चुका था, तो question कर लेते हैं। Is there anything that you feel कि miss हुआ है, तो please let me know. TIG, MIG हो चुका था, ठीक है। So let us conclude this lecture, but before concluding, let me give you the mind map. तो देखो, draw the mind map of welding. As soon as you hear welding, you should come to know about these terms. So, we have started welding. Welding is nothing but a metal joining process. Metal joining process. Now, metal joining process, you can join two work pieces. First, with the help of heat. So, you enter into fusion welding. Fusion. Second, solid state welding. ठीक है, third, allied processes. ठीक है, please pay attention. Fusion welding में क्या आएगा? Fusion welding में क्या आएगा? देखो, it started with shielded metal arc welding. Then it moved to submerged arc welding. Then it moved to TIG, MIG. ठीक है, electro slag welding. ठीक है, all these happens because of the term, the first term, that is arc welding. So arc is a fusion welding process which includes submerged arc welding, like shielded metal arc welding process, submerged arc welding, TIG, MIG, electro slag. The second part in fusion arc welding is, ध्यान से देखो, कहाँ पे दिखाया जाए, इधर पे, resistance welding. ठीक है, रेजिस्टेंस वेल्डिंग. अंडर रेजिस्टेंस वेल्डिंग विच प्रोसेसेस वी हैव स्टडीड? अंडर रेजिस्टेंस वेल्डिंग वी हैव स्टार्टेड विथ स्पॉट वेल्डिंग, सीम वेल्डिंग, प्रोजेक्शन वेल्डिंग एंड फ्लैश बट वेल्डिंग. ठीक है, देन वी मूव टू सॉलिड स्टेट. अंडर सॉलिड स्टेट विच प्रोसेसेस वी हैव कवर्ड? अंडर सॉलिड स्टेट विच प्रोसेसेस वी हैव कवर्ड? फ्रिक्शन वेल्डिंग, एक्सप्लोजन वेल्डिंग, ठीक है, एक्सप्लोजन, फ्रिक्शन वेल्डिंग, एक्सप्लोजन वेल्डिंग एंड द थर्ड इज अल्ट्रासोनिक वेल्डिंग. ऑल दीज वेल्डिंग प्रोसेसेस आर क्रिस्टल क्लियर टू ऑल ऑफ यू. ऑल दीज वेल्डिंग प्रोसेसेस आर क्रिस्टल क्लियर टू यू. ऑल दीज वेल्डिंग प्रोसेसेस आर क्रिस्टल क्लियर टू यू. ठीक है, चलो. देन वी मूव्ड टू अलाइड प्रोसेसेस विच इंक्लूड सोल्डरिंग, ब्रेजिंग एंड एडेसिव्स. बट ठीक है, दिस वॉज द पार्ट दैट वी हैव स्टार्टेड विथ. दिस वॉज द पार्ट दैट वी हैव स्टार्टेड विथ. ठीक है, अब यहां पर ध्यान देना. आर्क यूज ओनली हीट टू परफॉर्म द वेल्डिंग. रेजिस्टेंस यूज वॉट? हीट प्लस प्रेशर. Both resistance and arc welding comes under the bigger heading of fusion welding. Solid state takes only pressure, and here none of the above is utilized for performing operation. Yes or no? ठीक है, ये भी clear. Third important topic. From where you will get the numerical? So this part contains numerical. Resistance welding contains numerical. So your 99% of the numericals will be covered in arc welding and resistance welding. That's it. Solid state allied mein nahi hota hai. Apart from that, fusion welding mein hi kuch special processes bhi hoti hain. Theek hai? For example, fusion welding ke aur bhi types hote hain. So let us see one by one. Let us term them as special welding processes. Special welding processes. So in special welding processes, we have discussed about first gas welding, second thermite welding, third electron beam welding, fourth laser beam welding. ठीक है, फिर उसके बाद यही मेन तो यही रहती है, एक फिफ्थ भी रहती है, प्लाज्मा आर्क वेल्डिंग. प्लाज्मा आर्क वेल्डिंग, ये हमने शायद प्लाज्मा आर्क वेल्डिंग नहीं किया, तो प्लाज्मा आर्क वेल्डिंग इज सेम. ठीक है, मैं अभी आपको बता देता हूँ. प्लाज्मा आर्क वेल्डिंग, दिस इज योर एंटायर सिलेबस फॉर वेल्डिंग. यू शुड हैव अ माइंड मैप ऑफ दिस थिंग. यू शुड हैव अ क्रिस्टल क्लियर माइंड मैप ऑफ दिस थिंग दैट व्हाट इन वेल्डिंग. वेल्डिंग में चार कैटेगरीज होती है, फ्यूजन, सॉलिड स्टेट, अलाइड एंड स्पेशल वेल्डिंग. फ्यूजन में दो रहते हैं सब पार्ट्स, आर्क एंड रेजिस्टेंस. सॉलिड स्टेट में थ्री सब प्रोसेसेस. आर्क इज हैविंग फोर सब प्रोसेसेस, रेजिस्टेंस इज हैविंग फोर सब प्रोसेसेस, अलाइड इज हैविंग थ्री सब प्रोसेसेस एंड स्पेशल वेल्डिंग में पांच टाइप की स्पेशल वेल्डिंग है. ठीक है, इलेक्ट्रो गैस या इलेक्ट्रो स्लैग बोलते हैं इसको. ठीक है, डिपेंडिंग अपॉन कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड इज यूज या फिर ठीक. ठीक है, इज इट क्लियर? So the only thing left is plasma arc welding. So let us wrap up this lecture. एक important तो भूल ही गए. The fifth part is defects that we will be covering in next lecture. The next part is defects that we will be covering in next lecture. And I think deeply we have covered the entire welding. If you still have doubt, please reach out to me. और इससे ज़्यादा depth में आपको plus पे पढ़ाया जाता है, because plus पे interaction बहुत अच्छा होता है. ठीक है, कंटेंट हम दे सकते हैं, डीपीपीज वी प्रोवाइड, सो लॉट्स एंड लॉट्स ऑफ स्टफ इज देयर. 99% ऑफ द सिलेबस दैट वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस हियर विल बी देयर इन योर एग्जामिनेशन. जो आपके क्वेश्चन पेपर में क्वेश्चन आएंगे, those questions will be from these lecture itself. For production, I am taking the guarantee. That's it. None of the subjects, none of the teacher takes this guarantee. I am taking the guarantee for production. Okay, is it clear to all of you? Let us understand something more about plasma arc welding. देखो, सेम यही चीज रहती है. ये जो आपका एक कॉलम रहता है, जैसे प्लाज्मा आर्क वेल्डिंग प्लाज्मा रहता है. सपोज दिस इज योर वर्कपीस दैट नीड्स टू बी जॉइंट. दीज टू वर्कपीसेस आर देयर. सो व्हाट विल हैपन, यू हैव अ इलेक्ट्रोड टिल दिस पॉइंट. सपोज दिस इज एन इलेक्ट्रोड. Now, electrode is coming in. Electrode is leaving this. That is, electron is coming this way. But at the same time, I am passing a gas through this column. So, this area becomes plasma. Due to the interaction of gas and electron, it becomes plasma. Okay, simple. And this plasma reaches up to a value of 12,000. To 20,000 degrees Celsius, and it is having highest heat affected zone. Highest heat affected zone. Is it clear? So that is why plasma arc machining is only utilized when we require very high amount of heat. Otherwise, it is of no use. ठीक है, यूटिलाइजेशन तो बहुत है प्लाज्मा आर्क वेल्डिंग के, बट मोस्टली वी अवॉइड प्लाज्मा आर्क वेल्डिंग बिकॉज हीट अफेक्टेड जोन होता है. दिस हीट अफेक्टेड जोन मेक्स द प्रोडक्ट वीक, मेक्स द प्रोडक्ट वीक. इज इट क्लियर टू ऑल ऑफ यू? चलो, सो प्लाज्मा आर्क मशीनिंग, प्लाज्मा आर्क वेल्डिंग इज ऑल्सो कंप्लीट. ठीक है, चलो, एनीथिंग एल्स? ये भी हो गया. वेल्डेबिलिटी बताया था मैंने, वेल्डेबिलिटी का कॉन्सेप्ट बता दिया था आपको. चलिए देखते हैं, वेल्डेबिलिटी भी देख लो. हेलो, ठीक है, चलो. गिव द हेडिंग वेल्डेबिलिटी. ये मैं आपको पहले बता रहा हूं, फिर भी बता देता हूं दोबारा. Please write down the formal definition and then I'll explain you. It is defined as capability to be welded. देखो, कॉन्सेप्ट आपको पता है वेल्डेबिलिटी की. अगर मुझे ये वर्कपीस को वेल्ड करना है तो इज इट इजी टू वेल्ड दिस वर्कपीस, दैट विल टेल द वेल्डेबिलिटी ऑफ दिस प्रोडक्ट. बट यू हैव टू राइट द फॉर्मल डेफिनेशन इन ईएसई पेपर, दैट्स व्हाई आई एम मेकिंग यू राइट. ठीक है, इट इज डिफाइंड एज द केपेबिलिटी टू बी वेल्डेड इन टू अ स्ट्रक्चर that contains specific properties required for utilization. ठीक है, देखो एक छोटा सा एग्जाम्पल है, वो तो लिख ही लो आप. ठीक है, दिस इज एल्यूमिनियम. यू ऑल नो दैट एल्यूमिनियम इज हाईली ससेप्टेबल टू ऑक्सीजन. यस और नो? अभी हमने थर्माइट वेल्डिंग में देखा था. तो क्या करता है ये, अपने ऊपर एक लेयर बना लेता है. देयर इज अ लेयर ओवर ऑक्सीजन, ओवर एल्यूमिनियम. रेड कलर की लेयर दिख रही है, नाउ दिस लेयर इज एक्चुअली ड्यू टू द रिएक्शन बिटवीन एल्यूमिनियम एंड ऑक्सीजन एंड इट इज नथिंग बट अ लेयर ऑफ Al2O3. नाउ Al2O3 इज अ सिरेमिक मटेरियल, इट इज हार्ड एंड ब्रिटल. हार्ड एंड ब्रिटल, इफ इट इज हार्ड एंड ब्रिटल डोंट यू थिंक इट इज वेरी डिफिकल्ट, very difficult to weld. Yes or no? Very difficult to weld. So that is why we say that aluminium is having low weldability. And second important part, as you increase the carbon content, the hardness increases. And if the hardness increases, don't you think that weldability will decrease? Yes or no? Kyunki hard zyada hoga to melting point zyada hoga, melting point zyada hoga to it is difficult to weld. So that is why with the increase in carbon content, weldability decreases. With the increase in carbon content, weldability decreases. Is it clear? So weldability wala part bhi ho gaya. Sirf ek defect bacha hua hai. Apart from that, I don't think ki koi bhi part bacha hoga aapka. Theek hai? So thank you guys. Hope you have enjoyed the lecture. Aapko ye cheez samajh mein aa gayi hogi. Now one some important announcements. So in the month of July, there is a channel for solved previous year questions of GATE. ठीक है, solved previous year question of GATE, that is video solutions. So you have to join that channel. I'll be taking, mostly we will be covering, ठीक है, that approximately 20 years, 15 to 20 years of solved video solution, solved video lectures, which is one of the very big things in the market right now. But ek cheez aapko yaad rakhni hai, kya? Prakhar 21. This is my code. If you are joining an academy or any of your friends is joining an academy, this is the code that you need to apply. Yehi code apply karna hai aapko, that then you will be getting the personal guidance of me. ठीक है, सिंपल, बहुत सिंपल सी बात होती है. चलो, 20 इयर्स ऑफ सॉल्व वीडियो लेक्चर्स, ठीक है, दैट इज वन थिंग. सेकंड इंपॉर्टेंट अनाउंसमेंट, देयर इज अ बैच फॉर पीआई स्टूडेंट्स, देयर इज अ बैच फॉर पीआई स्टूडेंट्स वेयर आई विल बी कवरिंग ईच एंड एवरी वर्ड ऑफ द सिलेबस. वर्ड ऑफ सिलेबस विल बी कवर्ड. Each and every word of the syllabus will be covered. Each and every word of the syllabus will be covered. Is it clear to you? Is this thing clear to all of you? ठीक है, so this is the thing that is coming up in the month of July. ठीक है, and there are two different batches. Complete Hindi batch is launched by the name of Yelgar, and there is a English batch launched by the name of Beyoncé. ठीक है, by the name of Beyoncé. Is it clear? So there are two batches that are completely dedicated batches on YouTube itself. ठीक है, कौन को कहीं आपको नहीं मिलेगा, ये पूरा YouTube पे बैच है. ठीक है, which is absolutely free for you, complete batches. So we will try to cover up the syllabus by the end of November. But if you want the dedicated preparation, proper guidance, proper practice sets, daily questions, and everything. You have to, you can join us on an academy platform. While joining, you can reach out to me on Facebook for more details. And don't forget to use code PRAKHAR21 while taking the subscription, because it will give you directly 10% off. ठीक है, चलो, that is one important thing. इसके अलावा एक important announcement और है, ठीक है, that daily from tomorrow, daily at 12 p.m. we'll be having a free special class. On an academy. But काय पे होगी ये? So it will be in continuation. Forming and welding we did it here on YouTube. This is also free. You can join an academy. It is absolutely free for metal cutting. And please share this information with at least 10 of your students, 10 of your friends, because if I reaches up to 100 students in one lecture, I will be crystal clearly giving you free lecture on metrology as well. Is it clear? Chalo. So I think that I'm done for the day. Thank you guys for watching the video. Hope you have enjoyed the lecture. ठीक है, आपको समझ में आया होगा. Thank you, thanks a lot. Don't forget to subscribe this channel. If you are viewing this for the first time, don't forget to like the video. Mark your presence by liking the video. And thank you and all the best.